Hi all, I am Soumya, is working as assistant professor in department of costume design and fashion at KSR College of Arts and Science for Women. Today we are going to discuss about the topic woven design. Woven fabrics are made by two or more set of yarn interlaced at right angles to each other. Much variety is produced by weaving. Woven cloth is formed by interlacement of threads, namely warp and weft threads. These threads are interlaced with one another according to the type of weave or design. The warp threads are those that run longitudinally along the length of the fabric, and weft threads are those that run transversely across the fabric. For the sake of convenience, the warp threads are termed as ends and weft threads are termed as picks or fillings. Classification of woven structure. Woven structures are classified into following categories. They are simple structure, compound structure. In case of simple structure, there is only one series of warp and weft threads. These threads interlace with one another perpendicularly. All the neighboring warp and weft threads are parallel to one another and play an equally important role in determining the properties of the fabric. In case of compound structure, there may be more than one series of threads, of which one set forms the body or ground and other forms the figuring or ornamentation. Unlike the simple structure, the neighboring threads need not to be parallel to one another. Method of weave representation. A weave is the interlacing pattern of warp and weft. Two kinds of interlacing are possible. They are warp overlap, in which warp is above weft. Weft overlap, in which weft is above warp. There are two practical methods of representation. They are linear canvas. In the linear method, each warp thread is represented by a vertical line and each weft thread by a horizontal line. The point of intersection of lines corresponding to the warp overlap is marked by dot, and the point of intersection corresponding to weft overlap remains unmarked. Though this is a simple method, it is seldom used because the designer has to draw plenty of horizontal and vertical lines, which is time consuming. In the canvas method, a square paper is employed on which each vertical space represents a warp thread, each horizontal space representing weft thread. Each square therefore indicates an intersection of warp and weft thread. To show the warp overlap, the square is filled in or shaded. The blank square indicating the weft thread is placed over the warp. Next one, beam repeat. The repeat of a beam is a quantitative expression of any given beam. It indicates the minimum number of warp and weft threads for a given beam. It comprises of warp and weft repeat. The size of the repeat may be even or uneven depending on the nature of the beam. In elementary beams such as plain, twill, satin, etc., the repeat size is normally even. However, in beams such as honeycomb, huckleback, and repeat size may be even or uneven. For any beam, the repeat size is sum of the warp and weft floats. Thus, in case of 2x1 twill, the repeat size is 3x3. It is in common practice to denote one repeat of a beam on a design paper. Basic elements of woven design. There are three basic elements of woven design. They are design, draft or drawing plan, peg plan. The design indicates the interlacement of warp and weft threads in repeat of the design. It is made up of number of squares which constitute the repeat size of a design. The vertical direction of the square indicates the picks and horizontal direction indicates the ends. A blank in a square indicates the warp goes below the corresponding weft, and X mark in the square indicates the warp floats above the weft. The draft or drawing plan. It indicates the manner of drawing the ends through the heel eyes and is also denotes the number of heel shafts required for a given beam repeat. The choice of the type of drafting plan depends upon the fabric woven. The peg plan or lifting plan. It provides useful information to the weaver. It denotes the order of lifting of heel shaft. In peg plan, the vertical space indicates the heel shaft and horizontal space indicates the peg. The peg plan depends upon the drafting plan. In case of straight draft, the peg plan will be same as the design. Hence, no peg plan is necessary in the case of straight draft. Thank you.